Okay, so there's something about AL, which is like a different time. Okay, anyway, you don't, hang on. I'll explain that in a second.
What a bitch. Yo, we make your robot.
History of the First Crusades by Pierre Amédée de la Sade. Hey. The dates indicate
so,
AL, and
AL,
it looks like 4,000
like
years have been added to our calendar.
Okay. So AL
oh, that calendar counting system again.
Okay. Okay. Added.
So I've already did all these choices.
The Crusades took place not long after the year 1,000. Here all the dates say 5,000 and something. I'm guessing this dating system begins 4,000 years before the calendar that we use. Yet, I'm getting the feeling that there's something else, another small detail, but what is it? Or how Louis VII, King of France, eager to be pardoned for the death of thousands of innocent people in the fire of the Church of Vitry, convinces the Pope to authorize him to lead his own crusade. The result, in Germany, a new outburst of violence against the Jewish community, and a monumental fiasco by poor Louis VII, cuckolded by his wife's uncle.
Yeah. Yeah, so I already did that. That's what I did this one already.
Yeah, okay.
That's the first one I did, where it says 4,000. So here's a bunch of them.
Yeah.
So it's 9,000 something. I just don't know.
The author is Pierre Amédée de la Sade, none other than the Grand Master of the Masonic Lodge of Paris. Now I understand why the dates are offset. He's using dates based on the Annalusis, year zero of the Masonic calendar, by adding 4,000 years to the Gregorian calendar. But I thought that calendar starts in March.
Starts in March, so that's 90 days. January, February, March.
Yeah.
No, 50 days.
February,
starts in March.
February's only 28.
So it's 2 months off, right? There's also two, it's 4,000 years and 2 months off.
So it's something. So what, so this would be 5,000,
yeah,
100, no, sorry, 4,000?
That you have to subtract for. So it would be in
1,192.
Yeah. In 1192.
1192. Okay, so that's one option. Okay, what's another option then? Then it starts in March. That's 2 months. Let's just do 2 months. Okay, so that's 6 days.
We don't. Do we have these?
I don't know.
Do you have months?
I can click these and see what happens.
The famous call from Pope Gregory VIII in his Odita Tremendi bull of 5187. Oh, the crusade where Richard the Lionhearted distinguished himself. It states the first sea blockade of Saint-Jean d'Acre was broken in the 12th month of 5190 AL, whereas the siege had been going on for 2 years.
2 years for 92, okay? So, it could be.
Wait, no, that, no. See, the 12th month of their calendar would be
9,000.
It would be February, because their calendar starts in March. So the 12th month.
12 is the last month of the year. Of our year.
No, of their
year. Their year. Because their year started in March.
Yeah. 12th month of their year,
oh, okay.
AL.
Okay, so,
would be
so a month never carried over then. Or it just did.
Yeah, they still have 12 months. But like their January is actually our March.
Gotcha. So they start New Year's on March.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. So then there's 4,000 years added. So am I subtracting or am I
so
adding?
You're, like that happened in our system in 1,000 something.
190.
Yeah.
So what you're saying is this is one.
Yes.
1,192.
Well, I got it wrong. It doesn't matter. Well, I got it wrong. It doesn't matter. Well, I got it wrong. It doesn't matter. Doesn't work, damn it. I really thought I was close. 1190. Isn't the right date when History of the First Crusades by Pierre Amédée de Lasalle? Hey, the dates indicate AL and it looks like 4,000 years have been added to our calendar. Oh, that counting system again. Damn it. I really thought I was close. 1190. Isn't the right date when you subtract 4,000? I must have missed a subtlety.
Wait. That's when the date is counted. No. It was 91. If you're at the 12th month.
Well, I got it wrong. It doesn't matter.
I got
in!
Got
it!
Well, not like that. I feel like
that was a triple effort.
Let's see what you've been hiding, Lord Murderer.
That was a hard one.
Yeah.
Weakness of the Human Psyche by Guillaume Trimoire. He says, it is possible to drill an idea into someone by constant daily repetition until the mind gives in. Some of those forces are pushing toward the west. On it, Mortimer's placed little feather symbols at different points toward which the Spanish are headed. Could he be fueling Indian resistance to slow down Spain? This shows the forces present in America.
Oh wow. Analyzing? That was bullshit analyzed.
I tried to fire like from that distance.
Map of the Orient, indeed.
Yeah, there was something on the globe, like in the middle.
Oh, the dagger. Let us see if you have the courage to face me alone.
That gold was not hard to figure out.
This is my mother's writing. I've picked up her trail. What is she up to? Obviously, she wants to lure Mortimer somewhere, but where?
It's not always like this.
For Mortimer is his stone sword. It must be intentional. It looks like a decorative sword, like from a statue, for example. And judging by the state of it, I'm guessing it's been left outside for a long time. absolutely got to find out where it came from. Locked. The table of alchemical elements. So, Lord Mortimer also studies alchemy? It seems like he's interested in everything. Chest with a motif representing the alchemical symbol of fire.
I need 7?
What?
No, we're not unlocking that. We're gonna find 2 keys.
Okay.
There's good.
Yes.
Okay, that's one.
A chest with a motif representing the alchemical symbol of fire. Seeing things, or is that an actual von Leeuwenhoek microscope? Incredible. Mortimer really is at the cutting edge of science. Even at the Order, it took us ages to get one of those. Carmelite water. They say that if you drink this, it gives you a real boost. That must be for writing the homing pigeon mask. An iron mask. I wonder who it's for.
Iron mask?
Some goat skulls, chicken legs, 3 rusty old nails. We're about to look. A pack of tarot cards. Has he been reading the cards? Mortimer? That would surprise me. Must be for writing the homing pigeon messages. A skeleton by the name of Gustav, if the plaque on the plinth is anything to go by. Mortimer's given a name to his anatomy. These are feathers. Pigeon, probably. Looks like obsidian or onyx.
It's a Pokemon!
Must weigh a ton. Strange. I don't recognize the alphabet. I wonder where the pictograms are from. It isn't Egyptian or Hebrew. There are 2 inscriptions on the sides as well as on the top. No way to know what's underneath. Absolutely no idea what it's for, but I find this cue fascinating. Something strange about this table. Little Surgeon's perfect collection.
Yeah, I don't need to examine it. We all know it's important.
Preservation using formaldehyde. Just as disgusting as ever. Three rusty old nails. They're about 20 centimeters long. Chest with a motif representing the alchemical symbol of fire.
Okay.
This could potentially just give me more.
Right. Okay. I'll try it. Let's go for it.
A key with a water symbol. Collector coins.
Have you seen any other, water symbols?
No, not yet. I think the water's going to be next.
So maybe you missed the key?
Am I seeing things, or is that an actual von Leeuwenhoek microscope? Incredible. Mortimer really is at the cutting edge of science. Even at the Order, it took us ages to get one of those. Look, a pack of tarot cards. Has he been reading the cards? Mortimer? That would surprise me.
I need the next episode to happen so I can sleep. I think I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
It is a typical draw in a line that answers a specific question. To the left, temperance, that announces a reward for one who patiently waits before taking any action. And in the middle, the chariot, which symbolizes triumph and business success. To the right, the emperor evokes a future full of power and stability.
So patiently wait, do business, become powerful, you got. Yeah.
Anything fire? No.
Just walk here and see.
A skeleton by the name of Gustav, if the plaque on the plinth is anything to go by. Mortimer's given a name to his anatomy skeleton. That's morbid. Weakness of the Human Psyche by Guillaume Trimor. He says it is locked. Oh shit. How am I gonna get out of here now? Table of alchemical elements. So, Lord Mortimer also studies alchemy? It seems like he's interested in everything. That must be for writing the homing pigeon messages. Some goat skulls, chicken legs. Now we all know 3 rusty old nails.
They're
about 20 centimeters long. Some goat skulls, chicken legs. Now we all know something strange about this table.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, I feel like we should.
What kind of experiments does Mortimer carry out here? It's a dissection table. So Mortimer does autopsies. Here on his desert island.
But do you want to do custom games later?
Who's he doing like autopsies on then?
Like at nighttime?
I missed it so bad!
Yo, he's immune to everything. There's something with his cube.
Yeah. Wait. Were the inscriptions also?
These are feathers. Pigeon, probably.
Like on the wall?
On the wall or on the alchemy thing?
Well, he said he's never seen that.
This looks like the same mechanism as the one on the other side.
Oh, you gotta be fucking kidding me. I don't got any more to think about the lock.
We gotta find another date.
It looks too easy. It could be a trap. Looks like the same as the one on the other side.
Oh no, they found the tires!
Whoa. If the grid closes a bit more every time I enter a wrong date, I'd better not mess up again. It doesn't seem to be working.
Are you fucking kidding me, Rap? Are you kidding me? I gotta get this right or I'm locked.
Okay, let's look for a date.
Alright, we're looking for dates.
Weakness of the Human Psyche by Guillaume Trimore. He says, it is possible to drill an idea into someone by constant daily repetition until the mind gives in. Moreover, it shows a fair number of sea voyages being organized towards the American continent. No doubt with slaves. How many men are broken in this trade? Tens of thousands each year, according to what people say.
You can stream the games if you want. Like, you don't have to stop and not... Oh my god, I don't...
Oh shit.
I love crossovers, so seeing you guys together is dope.
Yo.
Yay!
<What's up?
laughs> Oh, shit.
I thought that said Buttwood.
There's a lot of things there, but 16.
Does that even add 2,000?
Oh,
it doesn't even add 2,000. Maybe I'm supposed to get it wrong.
It shows the forces present in Europe. It's clear that France is surrounded by her enemies. However, a large number has been underlined in bold. 26 million. I know what it is. It's an estimation of my country's population. All our neighbors have far fewer inhabitants. Indeed.
26 million.
There's another one.
Give me another number. We need another number. So if I get this wrong, this comes down.
Can I go back to the other side? The other part of the room?
Maybe I can't click on where the hole was.
Preservation using formaldehyde. Just as disgusting as ever. Strange. I don't recognize the alphabet. I wonder where the pictograms are from. It isn't Egyptian or Hebrew. There are two inscriptions on the sides as well as on the top.
Do you like my forehead?
No way to know what's underneath. Absolutely no idea what it's for, but I find this cue fascinating. These are feathers. Pigeon, probably. An iron mask. I wonder who it's for. Three rusty old nails. Some goat skulls, chicken legs. Now we all know what that's for.
God damn it.
table of alchemical elements. So, Lord Mortimer also studies alchemy? It seems like he's interested in everything. Am I seeing things, or is that an actual von Leeuwenhoek microscope? This looks like the same mechanism as the one on the other side.
I can use one free thing if I want. I could do, think about the shape of the cylinders, think about the mechanism as a whole. I could do one of these two if you want me to. Get this. Think about the shape of the cylinders, why?
Yeah, I don't know, I...
We might as well, I have nothing else to do.
The mechanism passes through the wall. The wheels are the same on both sides. Chances are the combination I used on the other side works on this side too.
1191. Should we try on the other side? But it has to be 1191 on the other side.
Actually, you like sniper.
It's 9949.
This looks like the same mechanism as the one on the other side.
I feel like the nails and all that, we would have picked a log or something. You know what I mean?
We would have got
unlock that other thing, and then he would know or something.
Well, I feel like if we couldn't figure out the mechanism, we'd have been like, you know what? Let's pick the lock to the other door that we kept saying was locked.
Yes.
And then we would probably have met Peru.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
You know?
I don't have any heals. Well, I have bandages in the first day.
Mark.
1%.
I'll show you after. Never mind. You guys are in the top 26 minutes. Alright, now what do we do?
Wanna go for buildings a bit?
Arch, geographic, and history. I feel like I'm gonna need to know that soon.
Probably, yeah.
Four. So when I do blue, I don't need any points.
Oh.
Or when I do it once, I can do it now, I just need to use stuff.
Okay. That's good.
Okay, and then when I find books, I can use a script, so I can give me a point on stuff. So politics, don't care. Science, I'm gonna start doing science.
Yes.
Questions, grammar, as well as physical language.
I feel like
this one here, alchemy.
Yeah.
We're gonna need that. Politics. Analyzing the French Revolution is a major important.
Oh.
Ken already knows.
That's good.
This note is about a meeting with Lord Mortimer. There's no doubt about it. I need to find out where the sword that came with it's from in order to find Mother.
What?
You're joking, I hope. Don't tell me you've done that.
Really? How do you expect me to guess?
Oh, for God's sake, just ask them. We must absolutely inform Sir Gregory. How long has he been trying to collect all the spears?
I must have brought him the first one, 20-odd years ago.
Do you know if he has managed to get the original?
Well, in any case, he's got all the ones we had at the Vatican. He made me replace them with copies. But I don't understand your reaction. I'm sure it is nothing serious.
I can see very well you do not understand. You have done nothing less than sign our death warrants, and still you don't understand.
Someone is listening.
What? Monsieur de Richet, why not join us rather than find yourself eavesdropping?
I didn't want to interrupt you. I'm sorry.
Of course you didn't. So, my son, what can we do for you?
Speaking of books,
I didn't mean to spy on you, but you caught my attention. Your Eminence, I don't know what you said to Mr. von Bolna, but the poor fellow looks positively crestfallen.
Not at all.
Don't you believe it, Louis. I was just telling Monsieur about Lord Mortimer's burning passion for holy relics. You must have noticed he's a bit of a collector. Well, for years, he has been searching high and low to bring all the copies of the Holy Spear together. As I was coming here, I thought I'd bring him a few of them. That's all.
Be quiet, for God's sake. Please leave us, Monsieur. His Eminence and I wish to finish our discussion alone. Leave us now.
Golden elixir.
Sometimes when I'm like poisoned or something really bad, like a negative effect, it cures me.
Jesus. Monsieur de Richet. What brings you here?
To tell the truth, I was wondering the same thing about you.
It's rare for guests to wander about in the garden. I wanted to be alone for 5 minutes.
You look worried.
Worried? No. Resolved would be a more exact term.
Resolved to do what?
What's the point in answering? You wouldn't believe me anyway. I'll be leaving now because whatever it is you're up to, I do not want to know. Be seeing ya.
Tell me, aren't you even curious?
Curiosity killed a cat, Monsieur de Richet. I admit, I may have judged you wrongly. Watching you seek out Mortimer's little secrets might even be amusing if I didn't already know the consequences. See you later.
What scares you so much?
Don't mess with him, Monsieur. If he offers his help, refuse it. Keep your freedom and get far away from here while you still can.
Ariadne. In Greek mythology, she helped Theseus get through the labyrinth. Looks like there's a crack in the region of the heart. The state the stone of the statue is in reminds me of the sword. I'll bet my boots this is where Mother wanted to lure Mortimer. Just need to know why. Let's see. Crack as long as my finger. I guide the sword that will kill the monster. Let's see.
Do you want to look around first, I feel like? Maybe. Yeah. Well, maybe I want to see if the other.
Icarus.
A vagina!
Son of Daedalus and Nocrate. Impossible to mistake him with those wings. After flying too close to the sun, they came unstuck and he fell to his death. Pity.
I
am the innocent one, sacrificed for the sins of the father. Well, let's keep going. Theseus, son of Aegeus. He's the one who slayed the Minotaur. Wrongly positioned, I am the blind hero. I wasn't expecting an inscription like that. Looks like a crack has been made on his torso. As long as a finger. I'd say between 6 and 8 centimeters. I wonder if Mother managed to solve this enigma.
One, two!
Daedalus. He's the architect of the labyrinth. And if I'm not mistaken, he's also the father of Icarus.
Oh, the father of Icarus?
I am the architect of my own demise. Hey, there's a crack in this statue, too. The crack is thin and about as long as a finger. Here's the famous Arianus thread, thanks to which, if I remember rightly, Theseus avoided getting lost in the labyrinth.
Yes, you have to follow it. Oh my god.
I'm jumping on that.
Do not get lost. And it ends with the architect.
I wonder what this kiosk is doing in the middle of the garden. Too cramped to be able to do much. Well, there must be something going on there.
Oh, don't let me yet, I feel like.
What is that? It's like a sort of opening mechanism. It's up to the just to deliver judgment. Truth unlocks all possibilities. Son of Zeus in Europa.
Son of Zeus.
If I remember correctly, he was the king of Crete. Married to Pasiphae, he had many children, including the famous Ariadne, whom history remembers for her thread. Hey, there's a crack in that statue. His gesture sealed his fate. Theseus. He's the son of Aegeus. He became the mythical king of Athens, the unifying king. Pity, he's generally only remembered for having slayed the Minotaur. Wrongly positioned, I am the blind hero. I wasn't expecting an inscription like that. Looks like a crack has been made on his torso. Well, we'll soon see. What's wrong? Either I'm imagining things or my hand was pricked. It had poison on it. My head. I feel hot. Theseus. Let's try something else instead. Daedalus. If I remember rightly, he's the one who built the labyrinth for Minos. Hey, there's a crack in this statue too.
Well, the good news is I can feel myself.
Pasiphae, daughter of Perseus and sister of Circe. She married Minos and became the queen of Crete. Deliverance alone suffices not to wash away my humiliation. All right, let's continue anyways. Daedalus. All right, let's try again. You never know. Minos. The crack is in the region of the heart.
Oh, yeah. From him.
again?
You can't be serious, Manuel. You know that's not going to happen.
You must leave me alone now. I have agreed to everything. Even to...
Agreed? I wasn't aware you had a choice.
What's going on here?
I... What now? What else must I do to win back my freedom?
Obey me. Now get out!
What was that? That's the third time in 3 days. See if you're in there, Mother. A fragment of amber. Bandages. Someone's been patching themselves up. Looks like my mother took advantage of being in hiding to change her bandages, huh? This is silk. She must have used her own clothes. Damn it, Mother. Now what's happened?
Don't move!
Wait, I'm not armed.
Who are you?
Good God, Mother, what have you...
Tell me who you are!
Also scary.
Yeah. every episode, so like every episode, it's like part one, part two, part three, part four, part five, or part six. There's seven parts in this one, and each one was like an hour or two. Now we get to see all the answers. Huh? It's not even Telltale Light.
Yeah. But kind of.
All I know is Frank's on a plane.
Frank!
1-2-1-2-1-2.
Alright, we're back.
The only thing I can tell you is that Sarah had indeed changed. In your opinion, why would your mother remain in hiding over several weeks?
You must leave me alone now. I have agreed to everything, even to...
But you do realize your mother will have to accept the consequences of her acts.
I hope that your search will prove successful and bring Sarah back to us soon.
I'll be leaving now because whatever it is you're up to, I do not want to know.
Since then, we have become one and the same. We have officially erased the identity of my sister Emma. Emily Hillsborough. The woman with two faces.
Everyone seems to be a little unnecessarily heated. Don't forget where you are, please.
Don't move.
Wait, I don't...
So you've come at last?
Easy. Let me turn around. Oh my God, Mother, what has happened to you?
Who are you?
What? But, Mother!
Who are you?
It's me, Louis, your son.
No, you lie. You won't catch me out like that. Louis isn't here. He obeys his mother. He would never have come here.
Mother, I don't know what you've been through, but lower your arm, please.
You think I was born yesterday, do you? But it won't work.
I'm begging you.
One day you will fall.
Mother!
Why are you here?
I'm here to help you. You have nothing to fear.
If only it were so simple. You are evil incarnate. Every word that comes out of your mouth is sharper than a razor blade.
I don't wish you any harm. Really, Mother. It's me, Louis.
Don't speak to me about him. You will never get him.
Mother, stop torturing yourself. It really is me, Louis. How can I convince you?
If you really are who you say you are, what was the saying I taught you?
You've been telling it to me since I was 3 years old, Mother. How could I ever forget it?
Always keep your mind rational. And open.
You knew it. You are smart. You're getting me muddled up. Tell me, rather, whose place were we at when I told you I was coming here?
Mother, I really am your son. You can't trick me. We were in Paris. We were investigating an art dealer.
His name?
Oh, shit.
I just told you, you can't trick me. His name was Von Borchert.
My God, everything is lost then. I refuse to believe it's really you, Louis. Otherwise, all this would be for nothing.
Mother, I don't know what happened to you, but don't worry. Everything's going to be fine. I'm here for you and—
No, I ordered you not to come with me.
I received a letter and Lord Mortimer informed me of your disappearance, so I took the—
No! 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 It's not true. It's a nightmare. Don't tell me that! Have you spoken to him?
Oh, shit. She's completely panicked because I spoke to Mortimer. It seems she's afraid of what he might have said to me about her.
Did he speak to you?
Mother, I don't know what you're imagining, but don't worry. Everything will be all right. If you're worried about what I might think about Elizabeth Adams, honestly—
Oh, Louis! Elizabeth is the last of my worries right now. I did what I could for her, but it was too late.
Very well. Rational and open, Louis.
Since you arrived on the island, has anything strange happened to you?
Depends on what you mean by strange. Like me having visions, for example?
I knew it! It started! Oh,
hell,
Louis, I just wish I—
Yes, it's happened to me. Like when I was a boy, I find myself in someone else's body for the space of a dream.
Have you ever dreamed of a different place to the one where you were sleeping without being able to explain it?
No. But Mother, don't worry. I'm not losing my mind. Everything is fine. You used to give me a concoction to calm me down when I was little. So, just make some for me once we get back home.
Migraines? Loss of consciousness? Loss of control?
No, no, rest assured. All is well. I promise you.
What else?
Do you want to tell me about your relationship with Elizabeth Adams?
Louis, I don't know what you found out, but just know that I did everything I could to help her.
I'm sure you did, Mother. I'm not judging you.
You know, what she had to put up with was slowly gnawing away at her. Now shut up and listen to me. We might still have a chance. Something of utmost importance is going to play out right here.
What are you talking about?
A conference, Louis. I should think all Mortimer's guests have arrived by now, haven't they?
Yes, they have, since this morning.
Perfect. The conference will be able to begin. You will attend this conference, and you must find out what Mortimer is up to. Don't trust him, Louis. Understood?
Right. I'll do what you ask of me. But calm down, please, Mother.
Louis, I made a mistake by coming here. We are in the lion's den.
What do you mean?
Mortimer, Holm, their guests, watch what happens. Do you think it's normal that the representatives of the most powerful nations are here all on their own without anyone else? On an island in the middle of nowhere, in total secrecy?
No, not really, but—
Louis! They shape the world. They manipulate us. Everything is decided here and now. They create and break states, provoke wars, destitute governments, or decide who will be their leaders. Open your eyes! Nothing is impossible for them. They are capable of reaching everyone, wherever they may be. Through high society banquets, they model the future of us all, and it isn't at all an issue for them.
And? What do you propose?
It's time to act, my son. You will go to this conference, and from the inside, you'll do everything you can to prevent Mortimer's plan from going ahead smoothly. We can talk later. I'll explain everything.
But why?
Do as I say, Louis. It's of the utmost importance. Beware of Mortimer. He won't let anything stand in his way.
You promised me that after...
Yes, after. Go now.
Yes, Mother, I'm going. One more thing, Mother. Emily Hillsborough, Emma's sister, came to this island looking for her sister. She probably won't hesitate to take revenge and...
It's the signal that the conference is starting, Louis. Don't be concerned about the Duchess. She's the last of our worries.
Monsieur de Richet, you are expected at the conference. Yes. Please take the door to your left to join the guests.
A chest with a motif representing the alchemical symbol of water.
She asked him at last, and he could not help answering her, but she said he seemed quite angry at being spoken to.
But it is not sound, you know, it is not case.
Your conjecture is totally correct, I assure you.
I have suspected it for some time, but now
I have already told her so once, by your desire.
Are you quite sure, sir? Is there not a little mistake somewhere?
Yes, because she asked him at last, and he could not help answering. Yes, she said he seemed quite angry. He spoke to her.
But it is not sound. It is not sound.
Your conjecture is totally wrong.
It's like,
I have suspected it for some time, but now I am convinced.
I have already told her so much. By your desire.
Are you quite sure?
I really need that. That was really good. Yeah, the coins, I don't know what they do exactly. I just keep them.
Amber.
Oh my god. I think the more Amber I get, because I only have this many, I think I get more of these.
Oh, maybe that, okay.
I could be wrong. Alright, who are we
going to
talk to first?
That does seem
like... My son, glad you're here. It seems Lord Mortimer's been waiting for you to arrive before beginning.
What a pity your mother isn't here for the conference. I hope I'll be able to see her before I leave. I still have a very important letter to give to her.
Feeling all right, Louis? You look like you're miles away.
Everything's fine. Don't worry.
Lord Mortimer wants to talk to you, Louis. Don't make him wait.
Indeed, I rather believe he did.
I don't know if you ever found what you were looking for in the garden, but Mortimer is waiting for you. I suggest you get a move on.
You say it as if you were afraid of him. I sense that you have things you'd like to say, but something's holding you back. What is going on between you two?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing. I believed in him. I followed him to the best of my ability. I championed his ideas, defended his decisions, and then, without even realizing it, I became lost. The siren's song, Monsieur de Richet. You wake up one morning, not knowing where you are, and you think about everything you've done for a man who wasn't even worth it. For a man who has no respect for you, who uses you, and who drops you as soon as he no longer needs you. For me, it's too late now. But you... You still have a choice. Don't respond to his call, sir.
Good evening, gentlemen. Are we ready? The much-awaited conference is about to begin?
That is what we have all been waiting for.
I believe that Lord Mortimer wishes to speak to you before it begins. You should go and see him.
Whatever.
Are you quite sure, sir?
Okay.
Is there not a mistake
somewhere? Yes. Yeah, she's not acting by design. This is bad. I always get scared when I know they're giving you a lot of items.
Yes. Like,
ah, Louis, I've been expecting you. Thank you for joining us. We are about to begin our conference. Let me explain what is at stake.
Thank you kindly. But what do you expect of me exactly? My mother's the one who's supposed to attend, not me.
That is indeed what was initially intended. Unfortunately, she still hasn't been found, and my guests can't stay here indefinitely. The conference must begin, and it would be truly beneficial to the Order to join in the project. Consequently, I would like you to replace her during her absence. What is at stake here is of the utmost importance.
It's important that the French Order gets their say. And should you need any advice, don't worry. You are not alone, Louis.
Very well.
Really? Fucking three, dude.
In concrete terms, how do you organize your discussions?
A conference is always organized the same way. There are two masters of ceremony who determine an important subject.
You and Sir Gregory, I presume.
Exactly. We shall be the masters of ceremony. It was our obligation to each bring to the table several guests in order to debate a subject. Once the debate is closed, a decision will be made by a vote of all the participants.
By a unanimous vote. If the project is not agreed on by all, then it will be rejected.
And neither of the two masters of ceremony have the right to vote.
It's up to the guests alone to decide, Louis. In other words, us.
Gregory and myself are merely the go-betweens. Finally, if the project is validated, each guest goes home and starts working to make it happen.
It can take years.
Can you give me a brief explanation of the aim of it all?
Of course, Louis, I was coming to that. The aim of these meetings is to bring together the most influential people in order to think together about the future.
But the future of who?
Of the world, Louis.
Our desire is to steer the destiny of our respective countries for the good of all, and to no longer suffer the random hazards of history.
Can you give me an example of an event that was decided here before being implemented in the outside world?
Well, take the French Revolution. It was decided right here 2 years before its implementation in France.
Concerning the case of the French Revolution, I wasn't invited. But as far as the American Revolution is concerned, Louis, I can testify that we planned it 5 years before implementing it, for example.
Louis, let me keep you a moment. I would like to let you in on a secret before we begin, because I'm going to need your assistance. You see, the project I'm going to present concerns the territory of Louisiana in North America. It's currently Spanish territory, and I'm going to make the proposition to the Assembly for it to become French. My idea is to increase the territory of the United States. The first stone of this vast project consists of getting Spain to cede Louisiana to France. Once it becomes French, France will hand it over to the United States, which will then allow them to double the size of their territory. And that's where you come in. France and the United States, hand in hand, two democracies illuminating the world.
Why spread it over two phases? Why not announce the overall project immediately?
Unfortunately, if Spain were to hear that the intention of all this is to allow the United States to grow, they would never sign. Manuel Godoy is perfectly aware of President Washington's appetite. If the United States took Louisiana, Godoy would know full well that he will have lost the entire North American continent. Things must take place in several stages. Otherwise, the change will be too brutal, and he will have no choice but to reject the project. Take a look at them. Apart from President Washington, they all belong to monarchies. Do you really think they won't resist? Of course they'll fight, fearful as they are of losing their precious privileges. But the world needs visionaries, like you, like your mother. It's a pity Sarah isn't here to see it. She only knew about a tiny part of the project. I hope I can count on you, Louis. It's time to start now. I must ask you to keep it to yourself for the time being. Take a seat, follow the discussions. We'll have an opportunity to catch up later, and you'll be able to let me know your thoughts.
Blast it, Mother. You didn't know about everything. His project is commendable. Why tell me to beware? Could you have gotten it wrong?
My friends, I propose we get started. First of all, I would like to thank you for taking the time to come.
The honor is ours, my lord.
As per our custom, here we are all together to discuss the face of tomorrow's world. Even though there may be certain tensions between our nations, I must ask you to keep an open mind. As Sarah de Richet is unable to be among us, please welcome Louis de Richet, who will represent the Golden Order and will vote on its behalf when the time comes.
Welcome among us, Louis.
welcome, Monsieur.
I hope he'll be more effective than his mother regarding the protection of the King of France. The Order has proved particularly inefficient.
Come, Manuel. You're not going to spoil our visit. The Order's mission was not to protect King Louis XVI, as far as I am aware.
We are talking about a king of divine blood, for goodness sake. It seemed obvious to me he needed protecting. If the Golden Order wants to pride itself on being an influential organization, it should have kept him alive.
Thank you all. I am honored to be among you today. I will strive to represent the interests of the Order as best I can.
Perhaps we may begin, Lord Mortimer.
Certainly. I have a dream that our nations will continue to support each other, more now than ever before. A dream that, for the sake of common good, we will do what it takes to ensure stability in the modern world. I have a dream that we shall lead by example and ensure that the American territory may remain in peace.
Thank you for the thought, Lord Mortimer, but I don't see where you're leading.
I'm coming to it, Mr. President. I need not remind you that North America is currently divided between the United States on the East Coast and Spain, which occupies the remaining two-thirds of the continent. Well, I propose that Spain cede the center of the continent to France, namely, all of Louisiana.
Louisiana? But, well, it is not for sale. Lord Mortimer, I sincerely hope I have not come all this way just to hear you ramble on about what Spain should and should not do. When we went to all the trouble of gaining the territory a few years ago, it was not just to lose it today. Have I made myself clear?
What did I tell you, William? You speak of union, and yet here you are, about to tear us apart.
Duke Manuel, I perfectly understand you. But rest assured, you will soon adore my proposition. You shall see.
Well, since you give me the choice, my good fellow, allow me to doubt it. However, I am impatient to hear what Spain could possibly gain from the sale of Louisiana.
I never spoke of a sale, my good fellow.
What? I do not understand.
There is one more territory left to conquer, if I'm not mistaken, in the Northwest. It is, of course, occupied by your notorious Indians, but...
We shall soon be rid of the savages, so that is not the question.
Duke Manuel, I believe that Spain should cede Louisiana to France free of charge.
This is utterly grotesque, Lord Mortimer. What a strange example you set for your young protégé. Isn't that so, Monsieur de Richer? Do you understand anything of this proposition?
I must say, William, I find your project mostly disfavors me. I thought you were my friend.
And I am, Mr. President. That is why I'm doing everything in my power to calm your expansionist fervor. France, in Louisiana, should persuade you not to attempt anything to take the territory by force. Louisiana is a vast wetland where you would needlessly lose most of your troops. It would weaken you and offer certain nations the perfect opportunity to take back your famous United States. I am protecting you from yourself, George. Trust me.
I understand. But with friends like you, sir, I certainly don't need any more enemies. I hope you know what you're doing.
Am I imagining things, or does it look like Washington isn't aware of Mortimer's plan?
Not to put too fine a point on it, Lord Mortimer, but I doubt the Holy See would be in favor of Catholic Louisiana being handed over to secular revolutionaries and king killers.
I should think Monsieur de Richer has an opinion on this subject, does he not?
On the maps of Italy I saw in Mortimer's secret study, he had anticipated movements of troops across Italy. I wouldn't be surprised if he's planning an invasion of Italy by France, and if I push the notion a bit further, I can well imagine that Bonaparte's cannons, financed by the Order, will be used for that purpose. The noose is tightening around poor Piaggi's neck without him even realizing it.
I don't know if I'm the best person to speak about that, Your Eminence. Well, I think that the French army will enter Italy, and that the Vatican will do whatever France demands of it, if the Vatican wants to retain its place.
You are joking, I hope.
Lord Mortimer, I did not come here to listen to such nonsense.
What makes you think that, Monsieur de Richer?
Well, Monsieur Bonaparte, here present, has ordered a large number of cannons, and I wouldn't be surprised if they were to be used to keep Italy under control.
Come, sir. What a strange idea. I have enough on my plate with issues in Corsica.
If you say so.
You see, you're...
But Corsica is not where the cannons are to be delivered, is it?
Aye, but... Louis, you are quick-witted. I like you.
You seem to be overlooking something, Monsieur le Français. I also have backers who would be only too pleased to demonstrate the full extent of their fervor by defending the Vatican. Mi auguro che insegnerete l'educazione a questo giovanotto presuntuoso, Sir Gregory.
I hope that you will teach this pretentious young man some manners, Sir Gregory. It looks like I won't be just making friends here.
In any case, my lord, I doubt the English crown will agree.
Ich versichere Ihnen, Emily, nie Preußen wird diese Vereinbarung akzeptieren.
I assure you, Emily, the Prussian will never accept this agreement. Wollner looks like he's set on ruining Mortimer's plan.
Duchess, I am persuaded that we shall find a common ground.
That's enough, William. These are grave times. We don't care about the fate of Louisiana. That worthless expanse of putrid swamps interests no one but yourself.
Speak for yourself, my friend.
Hold on there, Mr. Royal Gigolo. Lower the volume, and let Sir Gregory finish.
Home Godoy, and now Volner? Mortimer's adversaries are ready to tear each other to pieces, and he takes a malicious pleasure in watching it happen.
How dare you!
Gentlemen, let us try to remain calm.
There you are, William. See where your projects have taken us, as per usual. Chaos! That's enough. I'm tired. We shall continue this discussion tomorrow, but please be aware that your project will never be ratified. Those who are opposed to this project, follow me. Are you coming with us, Monsieur de Richer?
Come, Gregory. I think Louis would rather stay. Wouldn't you, Louis?
The problem is, George Washington doesn't know that he was supposed to just give him the territories afterwards, like resell them.
Yeah.
I don't know if you have an alliance with her, alliance with him, and he's kind of new, but these two hate me.
I don't know.
As for me, I think I shall remain with Lord Mortimer, Sir Gregory.
You are committing a grave error, Louis.
Time will tell.
Oh, I killed him and I think I tagged you, right? Did I tag you?
My friends, I would like to thank you for staying.
Good God, William. What is this I hear about you reinforcing military power in Louisiana? I have no interest in having France for a neighbor, and you know that very well.
Calm down, George. Louis, explain our plan to Mr. Washington, please.
I would have been only too glad to, Lord Mortimer. Unfortunately, I'm not sure myself that I have fully understood all the details of your plan.
Oh, Louis. President Washington, the United States will double in size.
By what miracle have you...
You need to expand, George. You and France are the two major democracies in the modern world. It is necessary that you both become superpowers.
Are you really going to sponsor democracy throughout the world?
Of course, Monsieur Peru. That's why I don't want Spain to get too attached to those weapons. Please continue, Louis. Explain my vision to Mr. President.
By going through France, Spain won't suspect that it's you who's going to take possession of Louisiana.
They'll even believe that France will be a protective buffer between itself in California and you on the East Coast. If Senor Godoy was afraid that you might take the territory by force, now he is reassured. You would never attack France.
But why didn't you tell me before?
So that Lord Mortimer would appear to be isolated without support.
Exactly. You got it, Louis.
Lord Mortimer retains the advantage by advancing undercover. And for it to work, he needed you to act surprised.
William, you haven't changed. Always one step ahead.
One step ahead? You're joking. More like five.
On that note, my friends, it's getting late. Mr. President, continue to take offense over my project when we resume the conference in the morning. You do it to a T. And if Sir Gregory has the audacity to send you an emissary to convince you to go against me, do me a favor. String him along if you can. The more they believe we are divided, the more we'll have our hands free.
Only too happy to oblige.
Now, let us get some rest. We've got a big day tomorrow. Good night, gentlemen.
Good night.
Louis, if you have a minute, I would like to ask a favor of you. I'm going to require your services.
How can I be of help? Tell me all about it.
Our adversaries are many, and the closing vote of the conference will soon be upon us. Time is of an essence. So, I'll need you to assist me this evening.
How can I help?
I need you to go this very evening to persuade Senor Godoy to join us. He is the backbone of Gregory's resistance. Turn him round, and all the others will follow in such a stampede that Gregory will be able to do nothing but admit defeat.
Lord Mortimer, with all due respect, don't you think I'm the last person Godoy wants to talk to?
I'm sure you can do it. I believe in you.
Lord Mortimer, you're not telling me everything.
Let's say I wouldn't disapprove if the Right Honorable, though nonetheless choleric, Duke Manuel put you in his bad books. If it could motivate him to declare war on France, it would greatly serve our interests.
War? What do you mean?
I told you before the conference. The more we distract Spain from the Americas, the less it will have an eye on Louisiana.
But all the same, we're talking about a war in Europe.
Don't worry. That's why Mr. Bonaparte is with us. I am convinced we'll be perfectly capable of managing the conflict. And Senor Godoy is not a great soldier. He will not commit Spain to a long war that he won't be capable of managing.
I'll go straight away.
Thank you, my boy. And get some rest afterwards. Big day tomorrow.
Aren't you afraid our projects for Italy may be discovered before we... Oh, please excuse us, Louis, but I need to speak with Lord Mortimer in private.
No, no. What do you want, Louis?
I'm going to have a word with Duke Manuel, but you know him better than I do, I believe.
Yes. avoid any marks of respect and protocol pertaining to his rank. He's not fond of courtly manners.
Thank you for the advice, my lord. When are we supposed to vote?
The conference resumes tomorrow morning. That leaves little time for the little favor I spoke to you about.
Indeed. I'll go straight away. I shall be leaving you.
Dante's Paradise. Raise your head and be reassured, for what comes up here from the mortal world must ripen in our rays.
Yeah, I've never seen that happen either. Of all 1500 hours I've played. Bedard, where are you?
Monsieur Johann von Wohlen now. The alchemist is a young man. The Great Work of the Soul by S. Madone. Pure alchemy is a thought, an art that is performed on the matter of the soul. Great alchemists work to transform and perfect the latter by a series of processes known as the Great Work. There are four phases to attain the ultimate in spiritual fulfillment. The soul broken up must be purified by the alchemist. Nice program. The soul must be transformed in order to obtain sublimation by the recombination of the alchemist. It's tempting. Very metaphorical, as occult theories go. The human spirit being the prima materia of the alchemist. Golden elixir. A table of alchemical symbols. Someone circled the zinc symbol.
Oh, that was a... I didn't check that out.
President George Washington.
Manuel, where are you?
Where you at?
Manuel? Put up on the platform. Manuel, bro. Manuel.
Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi. Huh, that's me. Inferno by Dante. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here.
Lovely lectures Mortimer's giving to his guests. Very jolly.
Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi. Duke Manuel Godoy.
Ah, Monsieur de Richet. You wouldn't have seen Duke Manuel by any chance, would you?
I was going to ask you the same question.
I wanted to speak to him, but no one will open the door. I'm not sure he's in there.
If I want to pass through, I'll have to get Volner out of the way.
Excuse me, but I must fetch a letter for the Duke.
Very well, sir. You may pass.
Don Quixote. Talking without thinking is like shooting without taking aim. The Kiss of Judas, painted by Caravaggio. This is how Judas pointed out Christ to the Roman soldiers. Can you imagine a worse betrayal? Don Quixote. Prometheus. Punished for stealing fire from the gods and giving it to man. Brutus and his companions taking an oath to kill Caesar.
Devil's thorn. I'll keep it.
Maria Luisa of Parma. Although not Godoy's true love, the queen is his benefactress, according to some people.
Devil's thorn. I'll keep it.
Jeff's on, Amor.
doors to ours, but can we go to that place? From the balcony?
Oh, it's locked. Yeah. Well, no, I'm saying I haven't been in it.
But could we go from the balcony?
Yeah.
Okay. And that one.
Monseigneur, His Eminence Cardinal Piaggi.
Save it, it literally will stop me right here and I can